Hi, my name is Gabor, and in this video I would like to show you our new aquaponics test site that is controlled and monitored by the latest version of AquaShield. The whole system is located at the basement of my home and is around 2 months old. The whole system is specially designed for IBC Aquaponics, so it is an EBB and flow system. That means that the grow bed is flooded in every hour for 15 minutes and then drained again. We keep koi fish in a fish tank, we use a sump tank, and we have a biofilter at the highest point of the system. The whole setup is placed underground, so there is no natural sunlight. We use a 600 watts grow light, and so far it seems that the plants like it. The IBC system is controlled and monitored by our smart aquaponics controller, the AquaShield. The device is always connected to the internet, so we can check our system's key parameters in real time and also receive alerts. The AquaShield has also 8 controllable relays, so we can set up workflows based on the time schedule or on sensors parameters. I will explain it in details later. So the AquaShield is responsible for monitoring all water levels in the fish tank. All important levels are monitored by simple level switches that are built into the IBC tank. We already set up alerts for the sensors, so we will get an email if the tank is overfilled or the water level reached the lowest point. With this, you will notice if there's a leak on the fish tank or the overflow pipe is closed or clogged. At our first aquaponics system, we experienced both, so this feature will improve your system security significantly. The grow bed is filled with expanded clay that acts as a large biofilter. For the first test, we planted all kinds of different plants like tomatoes, cilantro, basil, pepper, and lettuce. We tried to simulate a diver's garden just like you would like to have at home for your own needs. The grow bed has an overflow pipe installed. The pipe keeps the water level below the top of the growing media, so the surface of the growing area is always dry. We also have another drain pipe installed, that is the second tower with the green cover. The second drain pipe is connected to the solenoid valve that controls the flood and drain cycle. The solenoid valve is connected to the AquaShield also, so it was super easy to create the cycle workflow through the AquaShield application. As there is no natural sunlight, we use a grow light that is also controlled by the AquaShield. The workflow that we use is simple. We switch on the grow light at 7 a.m. and turn it off after 12 hours. However, this workflow is super simple. You can create detailed programs for even months ahead. So you can have a grow light program from seeds to harvest. The water flows from the grow bed to the sump tank. From there, it is pumped back to the biofilter and the cycle ends with the fish tank. However, the pump in the sump tank is always on. It is also controlled by the AquaShield. Using the AquaShield app, we can easily switch it off for maintenance or just to admire the fish with an undisturbed water surface. AquaShield is also a monitoring device. At this time, we track the pH and EC parameters of the tank, the temperature of the air and water. There is an alert setup based on the pH, so we get an alerting email if the pH spikes or drops to a certain level. At the past, we had several issues related to pH swings, and it was almost always too late when we noticed it. With this alerting feature, you will be the first to know if there's a problem and you will have more time to act. Next to the pH and EC, AquaShield can also monitor the ORP and the dissolved oxygen in the water. Dissolved oxygen is crucial if you want to keep fish, especially if you have a high density in your fish tank. As you can see, AquaShield can handle everything to have a blooming garden and also gives you a peace of mind with its complex monitoring and controlling features. If you want to know more about the AquaShield or purchase our device, please follow the links in the description. Thanks for watching.